Welcome to how to turn a TP-Link router into a network storage server. This is my router. Make sure it has a USB port. USB 3.0 is recommended for optimal file transfer speed. In addition to the router, I use two traditional hard drives. I use two hard drives to protect data in case one of them fails. The two hard drives have the same capacity. Each drive is 1 terabyte in size. To connect two hard drives to the router, I use a hard disk box. It can install two hard drives. This is what it looks like on the outside. And this is what it looks like on the inside. Hard drive 1. HDD 1. Connection interface. HDD 2. Hard drive 2 connection interface. The special thing about this hard disk box is that it supports redundancy settings, also known as RAID settings. It supports 4 different modes. I am only interested in RAID 1. Read the instructions carefully before installing the hard drives. Only recognizes data stored on one hard drive and backs it up to another hard drive. Settings: switch 1 to number. Switch 2 to on. Note: if any hard drive fails, data will not be lost. Example: 1000 gigabytes plus 750 gigabytes equals 750 gigabytes. I set up RAID 1 as instructed. Switch 2 to on. Install the hard drives. Align the hard disk with the installation port to install and secure the hard disk. Hard disk 1. Secure it with screws. Hard disk 2. Align the hard disk with the installation port to install and secure the hard disk. Secure it with screws. Insert the installed hard disk into the hard disk box and secure it with screws. Because the router cannot format the hard drives, I connect the hard disk box to a computer via USB. Use the USB cable to connect the device to the computer. Don't forget to press the power button. Start. Disk management. Disk 1. The computer detects the new hard disks. Although there are two hard disks, the computer only detects one hard disk. The reason is that the hard disk box uses RAID 1. You format the hard disk drives. Volume label. NAS. This is the partition after being formatted. Disconnect the hard disk box from the computer. Connect the hard disk box to the router. Use a cable to connect it to the router via USB. Check the result. On a computer in the local network, I access the router settings page. I set up sharing on the router. Advanced. USB. USB storage device. Press refresh if the router does not detect the hard disks. And this is the hard disk the router detected. By default, the router has shared enabled on the local network. Address. The IP address of the router. I recommend you to share securely. Secure sharing. Enable. Shared account share default. The default password is hard to remember, so I changed it. Edit. You make sure the password is as required by the device. 12345. Save. Open the run window. Enter the IP address of the router. 192.168.0.1. The IP address of the router. Username. Admin. Password. 12345. Okay. Okay, successful. These are the steps to turn a TP-Link router into a network storage server. Thank you for watching. Map network drive. Enter the IP address of the router. Finish. Rename it for easy remembering. I upload any file. USB 2.0, so the speed is not as expected. I recommend using a router with USB 3.0. Also, you can access the shared folder from the internet. I have introduced how to do it on the channel. Good luck.